So my name's Peter Grayson, and right now we're at the National Institutes of Health in Building 10, which is the clinical center, which is where we take care of patients under research protocols at the NIH. So I'm focused on combating the disease known as vasculitis, which is a family of rare diseases that are characterized by inflammation inside of blood vessels, and these diseases can lead to life-threatening outcomes for patients. So I grew up in Charleston, South Carolina. It wasn't something that I thought I was going to be a scientist from the get-go, from birth. I wanted to be a musician and spent some time playing in rock and roll bands around the country, and then kind of meandered my way into medicine and came at it much later in life. So vasculitis is, among doctors, it's a scary disease. It's one that many doctors don't know anything about because it's quite mysterious. Wherever you have blood vessels, you can have a problem, and you have blood vessels throughout your entire body. So you can get a lot of bizarre symptoms. And typically what happens to a patient is they get something where they get a painful red eye, and then they lose sensation in their foot, and then they start coughing up blood. And all these crazy, bizarre things happen in sequential order. They go see millions of different specialists. There's a long delay, and finally somebody will put the pieces together and realize that this is a vasculitis. And we have made a lot of progress in the last 20 years. It used to be that these diseases would kill you within a few months of contracting them. And now patients do not die from the diseases anymore. And we're faced with a whole new challenges of managing these diseases as they turn into long-term illnesses. So this is the heart. And your aorta is this big tube that comes off the heart and comes down here and splits into the blood vessels of your legs. These are the blood vessels of your arms, and these are neck blood vessels going up to your brain. For patients that have a type of vasculitis called large vessel vasculitis, they can have problems and disease in the big blood vessels of their body. And so if vasculitis affects a big blood vessel known as your aorta, it can cause it to swell up and form an aneurysm. It can cause things to close down and form blockages. And so a patient will come in and they'll have no blood pressure in their right arm or no pulse in their left leg. We can comprehensively image all of the blood vessels in their body. And we do these kinds of imaging studies and figure out where in their vasculature there's disease. Where we are with these diseases is that people survive them, but they relapse, and they relapse unpredictably. And so we're trying to figure out things that allow us to predict what happens over time. So you're trying to actually figure out something within an individual patient that you can target treatments to. And I think in that setting, this is kind of a new age of discovery in medicine. Before, we used to be limited with what we could see or a couple of simple blood tests we can do, but now we're not constrained by hypotheses and by what people have done before us. You can actually really, in an agnostic fashion, categorize what's happening at cellular level.
Wait a little bit longer, the IV contrast gets excreted by the kidneys.
The way things are right now, there's so many different aspects of research that are going on that you can't know everything, but it's great if you're sitting at a table where you have representations from all the different kinds. When you're in medical school, they tell you that 50% of what you learn in 5 years is wrong. And that's kind of daunting because you're sitting there trying to study and take all this in, and you're trying to figure out which half you really need to know. But what that means and why that's really cool is because we're rewriting medical history continuously. You have the opportunity in medicine and in medical research to change the textbooks and to change the course of medical history in a very short time. And that's sort of, conceptually, that really excites me. If you find something that's surprising and interesting, it opens up a whole new box and you go down this tunnel, and there you're off and running and doing a totally different thing than you were doing the day before. And that aspect of the job is great. It's extremely challenging. It's constantly shifting. There's constantly interacting with new people who are bringing in new ideas. You just don't know what the next day is going to be, and that's really, really fun. Really, the journey is the destination. I mean, you just have to stop thinking about where you're going to be and what milestones you're going to hit in your career and just enjoy the ride, because it's a really incredible experience. Once you relax and realize that, you know, you're in a very fluid field that sort of rewards creativity and rewards hard work, and it takes you into just unexpected places. I think if, you know, we're often trained to want to hit milestones in our lives, and once you sort of let go of that a little bit, I think you realize how exciting this career is.